Hey.
You should have done yourself favor and died while you had chance, Kroshka.
Great. Where are you going?
If you can move, leave. Trouble never comes alone.
Right. Roger that, Rasputin. I'll get right the fuck out.
But I didn't. I couldn't. Where was I gonna go? So we came to an understanding. He would put up with me just as long as I pulled my own weight. And that was my shitty start to 6 long months.
It's been about 8 weeks now since I lost track of Claire. The old man pulled my battered ass out of the wreckage and patched me up.
As for the bracelet, mine never changed color.
And I never turned into one of those things.
Lucky me, right?
As soon as I was back on two legs, the old guy told me I had to help with hunting. Basically, it was on me to kill my own food. House rules.
Can you use gun?
More or less?
Good. You collect on bullets. You run out, not my problem.
Look, I get it. I won't be a burden.
When hunt is finished, you go to sawmill entrance deep in forest.
The big gate. I remember.
It's very important you get there by sundown. Otherwise, monsters will have Kroshka for dinner. Yum, yum, yum.
Well, thanks for scaring my appetite away.
I help you, now you help me. Get this beautiful after it's repaid.
Yeah, yeah. Just get this hunt on the road before you die of old age. I know I have to eat, but poor thing.
You will get used to it.
Fuck! I hate using guns!
Stop whining! Keep working! You need wash mouth out with soap.
All right, Barry.
Can eat those insects if you remember to cook through.
I think that's a really great idea. I'm not gonna try.
Then go search for the food you like. Snake, rat. Maybe you find a wild hamburger. Why are you still here?
Maybe because you didn't tell me nicely? I should keep moving. shoot them, or do you want to complain some more? Man, I got focused. How did Claire hold her gun again? Oh, right. Let me just pull up my good girl petticoat so it doesn't get dirty.
When you are gone, head for gate.
Yes, sir. We've got what we need. Can we call it a day?
Okay. This should be enough food.
Thank God. I can't wait to lie down.
Lie down? We finish early. You help me cut up meat.
Wow! Educational. I thought that was it. I couldn't take another second of getting muscled around by some man who thought he knew better than me. Why don't we find a way off the island, I asked.
Niet, he said. No point. You need face reality.
His house, his rules. But I wasn't about to give up hope. Not yet. All I kept thinking about was my dad, actually. That night, I had a dream Barry was on his deathbed. He looked really sad. Nobody was with him. Nobody to nag. He had no fire left. When I woke up, I realized I'd been crying. Then the day came when I really fucked up. The old man made me promise not to go out at night, but all we did during the day was hunt. I wanted to look for a way home, you know? But I ended up leading those freaks right to our doorstep instead. And everything went straight to shit.
You bring them here. You make them go away.
I'm sorry, just help me out!
I should make you. One of them gets...
feet.
Cover your mouth and I will...
in a rat run like this.
Correct. So we get in and get out.
I was pissed. Can't blame him, considering I almost cost us our hideout. He told me to face reality, to focus on surviving. And I should have listened. So I promised myself I would do better, work harder. As long as the island was stronger than I was, there would never be any escape. Around the 6-month mark after the tower collapsed, a new kind of monster entered the picture. Whatever it was, it started killing all the game on the island. You can imagine what that did to our "how fucked are we" rating. It was the old man's idea to ramp up our hunting. Better to stockpile than watch it all burn, you know?
Remember, back before sundown, island becomes more dangerous.
That doesn't leave us a lot of time.
When you have what you need, meet me by slope leading into forest. I will check situation from above. Be careful, Kroshka.
Yeah, you too. Another one of these fuckers?
You must not let it see you.
But what if it does?
Run. Absolutely do not try fighting.
Okay. Okay, this should cover us. Better head back. Mixed in with the supplies, we found a document. It was a list of islanders who had been taken away to the mines to become test subjects. When the old man saw it, his face turned white as a sheet. Irina, he whispered. It was one of the names on the list. I found out later that Irina was his missing daughter. The old man changed once he picked up his daughter's trail. Can't blame him. Fathers are built to worry. I should have figured that out about my own dad a little sooner and cut him some slack. It was weird that I knew Irina's name, but the old man refused to tell me his. I think he was scared, you know, of losing something else. So I did him a favor and never told him my name either. Groshka was good enough. But deep down, I wanted him to ask. I didn't believe we would find his daughter, but it hurt that he tried so hard to be alone. Let's go find out what happened to Irina, huh? Those things are probably out in droves. We better take them all out. Okay there? On while we can. We're not leaving till we find out what happened to Irina.
Do not carry yourself away.
Thank you.
Area's clear. Let's keep going.
As you say.
Thank you.
Moira will soon come.
All right. Let's patch ourselves up at least. Look at this. I think Irina wrote it. Without a single word, the old guy read his daughter's last words. I watched him as he faced reality, and I thought, I don't want to do this to my dad. I can't die here. If he wants to be overprotective, let him. I'd rather put up with that than make him spend the rest of his life wishing he protected me more. As for the old man, he and I came to the end of our road.
this island, I will die on this island. Here, with Irina.
You don't have to.
I do have to, but not you. You have whole life ahead of you, Kroshka.
It's Moira. Ask me my fucking name for once, you dinosaur!
You should wash mouth out with soap, Moira. And my name is Yevgeny.